Hello, my name is Andrei Farcas. I am a student at ICHB and this is my project based on learning, or PBL. For this semester, I chose to talk about colonizing the Earth's planet, Mars. In this video, I am going to discuss some general matters about Mars and also the big challenges that lie ahead. Mars is the fourth planet from the Sun and is approximately one-third of the Earth's mass. That means we will weigh one-third of our normal weight there. On average, the temperature on Mars is about minus 60 degrees Celsius. Also, in winter, near the poles, temperatures can get up to minus 125 degrees Celsius. Winds there usually blow with up to 32 kilometers per hour, but during dust storms, they can reach up to 113 kilometers per hour. If that isn't shocking enough, on Mars, the atmosphere is so thin, radiations can get through, and one won't last long without a spacesuit. The distances between Earth and Mars vary from 54 million kilometers to 401 million kilometers. At the minimum distance, it would take us at least 5 months to get there. In the last decades, Mars has been explored by the USA, Russia, Japan, China, and India. The most well-known and publicly documented robotic missions on Mars are Sojourner, Spirit, Opportunity, and Curiosity. Those missions have sent, over the past few decades, valuable information that showed us evidence of frozen water on Mars. Going to Mars. Now that we know the basic things about Mars, we need to talk about how we get there. First, we need a rocket, and NASA and Elon Musk have already designed the launch system for Mars. NASA designed the Space Launch System, or the SLS, which is the most powerful rocket designed by them since the Saturn V, the rocket that helped people go to the moon. NASA plans to use the SLS in the Artemis missions that will first go to the moon in 2024 and to Mars in the 2030s. Attached to the SLS will be the Orion spaceship that will serve as the control center and cockpit. After the fueling the SLS finishes, the Orion will undock from it, then dock to the Gateway, which is a small space station that can change orbits. After the last mission on the moon is done, the Orion will launch from the moon, dock again to the Gateway, that will change its orbit from the moon to the red planet, Mars. But NASA isn't the only institution that wants to go to Mars. SpaceX by Elon Musk will supposedly go to Mars by 2024 with the Falcon Heavy, which is the most powerful rocket in the world. After we get away from the moon's orbit and turn to Mars's, we'll have to land. Now, the best zone for us to land is somewhere near the equator because we can get temperatures as high as 21 degrees Celsius. Now, unlike Earth, where we need food, water, shelter, and clothing in order to survive, on Mars, we will need all of the above plus oxygen. Now, luckily, we already know that water is present on Mars as ice and that the atmosphere is almost 100% humid sometimes. All we need to figure out is a machine that can extract water from the soil of the atmosphere, like the wave arm machine made at the University of Washington. Conveniently enough, we know that NASA has the oxygen problem figured out too. We know that the Mars's atmosphere is 96% CO2 and CO2 is 78% oxygen. So NASA has MOXIE, a machine that can extract the oxygen from the Martian atmosphere. Regarding shelter, we will be able to stay in buildings with Martian soil bricks. NASA had already made some bricks with Martian soil in them, in which they added polymer plastic and heated them in a microwave. For clothing, we will need a spacesuit like the one created by Davin Neumann that blocks radiation, creates enough pressure for a human, and would keep us warm in the Martian atmosphere. As for food, in the beginning we'll try food packed from Earth until we'll be able to grow food on the colony. In conclusion, Mars is our best bet on creating a colony in our solar system, but seeing how hard it is, we should take care of Earth and still look forward to the plan of creating another colony on another planet.